tone. Please leave a message.
Walker and Evelyn. My name is Gunnar Bridges and I am 6 years old. I will be a first grader at Base Bridgesville Primary School. I'm a Rockety Holla at Wesley Chapel CME Church. My pastor is Reverend Dr. Doris L. Hicks. Thank you for joining us for the 2021 Carolina Region Women's Missionary March. Now take it away, Miss M. Blues. Bye-bye.
Thank you for such a lovely introduction, Little Master Gregory. My dear missionaries, clergy, lay, and guests, we welcome you again to our second virtual Lena Jones Rice Missionary March celebration. We're coming to you live from Greenville, South Carolina, where our motto is, yeah, that Greenville. Boy, do we have an event in store for you tonight. So, run and get your popcorn, your beverage, and your dancing shoes. And come on, come have a little fun with us. We will begin our program with the occasion rendered by Little Miss Mia Funderburk.
Greetings to Bishop and Mrs. James B. Walker, Conference Leadership, Mrs. Adrienne Spies, our Missionary President, and the Superlative Seventh. My name is Mia Funderburk, and I am a member of Langford Chapel CME Church in Monroe, North Carolina. My pastor is Reverend James McCoy. I am honored to be selected to highlight our occasion for this evening. The Lena Jones Rice March is held annually at annual conferences as a means of collecting funds for expansion within our region. Your $100 allows our conference leaders the latitude in expanding our work and territory of service to better serve God's people. What insight our past missionary leaders had in creating a fund to benefit all of us and building a brighter future for all of us. We all stand on their strong shoulders. Blessings to Mrs. Spies for her 8 years of excellence, and congratulations to all of the marchers tonight. Thank you and God bless.
At this time, please help me present our regional officers. From Charleston, Columbia, welcome President Sonia King.
I gotta pray. It's a mandate. Y'all know it. Yeah. All day.
From Durham, welcome President Eloise White.
I've been walking around within my soul. My time with you will make me whole. I got on my knees, I was trying to.
And from Winston-Salem, Greenville, welcome President Jacqueline Cox Smith.
And I can't be late, no. So I'm out the door and I'm on my way.
But I
don't wanna leave you, and I don't wanna go.
From the directorate, welcome Secretary Sister Diane Acker.
Everything we'll share, I wanna be with you
all day.
I've been walking around, I've been talking with, come on, sing it, say,
all day.
I'm determined to spend more time with you.
Welcome Treasurer, Sister Emma Mills.
My time with you. Come on, sing no more. Lay me down to sleep and I pray the Lord.
Welcome, Vice President, Sister Carolyn Stafford.
I better keep on praying anyway. I'm trying to figure out, what's really true.
Welcome, Past President Emeritus, Sister Donna M. Mays.
Teach me now, hear my heart. I want to be with you.
Welcome, Past President, Sister Laura Anderson Holloway.
My time with you gonna make me whole. All day. I've been walking around, I've been talking with you.
Come on, y'all,
y'all
raising up, Jesus.
I'm determined to spend more time with you.
And welcome, immediate Past President, Sister Faye Crowder Phillips.
Somebody get your dance on.
You gotta move.
I gotta pray. I gotta pray.
Got to be tough. It's a mandate. It's a mandate.
Ooh, I gotta pray.
And now, let's welcome the CME Connections' most conscientious and hardest working regional president, who has served 8 years with grace and style. Welcome, Sister Adrian Speed.
My time with you gonna make me
say it again.
All day. I've been walking around, I've been talking with you. Come on, y'all, sing it. Come on, sing.
I'm determined to spend more time with you.
All day. I've been walking around with you in my soul.
Carolina Region, please help me welcome our Superlative Sevens visionary leader who is innovative with seamless leadership skills during a pandemic, our shepherd, Bishop James B. Walker, and our poised and charming First Lady, Sister Dolores Woody Walker.
So I'm out the door and I'm on my way.
But
I don't wanna leave you. And I don't wanna go.
My time
with you, Lord, helps me to grow. So can I take you there? Can I take you everywhere? Everything we'll share. I wanna be with you. I've been walking around, I've been talking with you. Come on, sing it, say.
For Adrian Speece, our missionary president. We all have a role to play in this thing called life, be it filled to overflowing with joy or filled with a bit of strife. What we make of it is up to us to do as duty calls, for that's when the blessings flow from the source to one and all. From the day her duties were first assigned, she fixed her mind to meet each goal and accomplish them one at a time. Adrian Speece, for 8 long years, has been missionary president. And I think I can honestly say she did not let anyone or anything ever stand in her way. Don't let her size fool you. She's a strong black woman, setting up meetings, scheduling dates, and conference calls. But by the grace of God, she was able to do it all. Looking back on her administration, Not one area did she fail, because she's a woman of wisdom and knowledge, working through every minute detail. Sure, there were times she felt like giving up and quit, but she vowed to work to the finish. She made a promise to commit. We thank you, Adrian, for all your magnificent leadership skills. You opened doors to lead others. You made the impossible possible. You made it real. You have a genuine love for your missionary sisters in every step of the way. Mediocre was not an option. It had no place in your day. Your service has been fruitful. You've served with a warm and loving heart. But the time has come to leave your post. Now you must depart. Remember, just be you, the woman God designed you to be, a woman ever so deserving, and that you have lived a life of significance, because you are all about serving. Pass it on. We love you. God bless you.
Sex, lies, videotape. But if I talk about God, my record won't get played. let this take away from my spins, which will probably take away from my ends. I hope it take away from my sins. Bring the day that I dream about. Next time I'm in the club, everybody sing it out. God, show me the way, cause the devil's trying to break me down.
What a heartfelt salutation to a sister. At this time, please enjoy a skit created by Minister Brenda H. Springs in honor of our regional president.
Our presentation tonight is in celebration of our president, Sister Adrienne Speeds, for her 8 years of dedication and commitment to being great, according to God, and serving others. How do you achieve greatness in the eyes of God? By making yourself a humble servant. Of course, being a fallible human being, you may feel the temptation to build yourself up in the eyes of your neighbors. Don't do that. Instead, serve your neighbors quietly and without fanfare. Find a need and fill it humbly. Lend a helping hand and share a word of kindness. Do it anonymously. Take the time to minister to those in need. Then, when you have done your best to serve your brothers and sisters and serve our God, you can rest comfortably knowing that in the eyes of our Heavenly Father, you have achieved greatness. After all, God's eyes are the only ones that really matter. And now, we share with you the cast of greatness according to God. The characters are Sisters Parker Webb, the little girl who is helpful and polite, Kyla Webb, who's very competitive, Catherine Wright, who is also very competitive, Pamela Kelly, the grown-up, an innocent bystander reading her newspaper, Margaret Harrison, and Cheryl Berry, all illustrated by Minister Brenda H. Springs. I present to all greatness according to God.
I am.
No, I am.
You're crazy because I really am.
You're crazy because I really am.
Yeah.
Whatever.
There's only one way to settle this. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes?
My friend and I are having a small but pesky dispute.
Oh, quit trying to impress her.
I am not trying to impress her.
You really are.
But I'm really not.
Whoa, hold it. What's this argument about anyway?
To see which one of us is the greatest.
The greatest?
That's right, the greatest.
We need someone smart, someone fair.
Someone about your size standing on the street corner reading the newspaper.
I guess that would be me.
So you'll do it?
Well, okay.
Great, I will now prove that I'm the greatest by singing. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Ha, that's nothing. I'll now recite John 3:16. For God so loved the world, he gave his only son.
That's okay. I'll prove that I'm the greatest by praise dancing.
Well, I'll recite the books of the Bible. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy.
Oh, please. That doesn't prove anything. I know the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven.
Well, I can run faster.
I wish I could tell you, but...
Oh, no problem. I can do 100 jumping jacks.
Well, that's nothing. I can do 500 toe touches.
And I'll do 3,000 knee highs.
Well, I'll do 5 million twirls.
go on. Must decide who's the greatest.
Get up. I have a lemonade stand down the street and thought you might like a drink.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
Well, I better head back now. Hope you guys feel better.
Again, thank you.
And we have a winner.
Huh? Winner of what?
I finally know who the greatest is.
You mean me?
No, I mean the little girl with the lemonade stand.
But she didn't do any jumping jacks.
And she didn't even name the books of the Bible.
You're forgetting what Jesus said. He said, whoever among us wants to become great must be a servant.
So you mean being the greatest means you have to be nice to other people?
Yeah, exactly. That's what I mean. Well, I guess I'll sell this little old man. See you later.
Are you going to try to be the greatest servant?
Are you kidding me? Helping other people makes you tired.
Have you made someone happy or made someone sad? What have you done with the day that you had? God gave it to you to do just as you would. Have you done the things that you should? Did you lift someone up or push someone down? Did you give a smile or just wear a frown? Did you lighten a load or progress impede? Did you look for a rose or gather some weeds? What did you do with your beautiful day? God gave it to you. Did you throw it away? It's up to you.
So do more. Do more than belong. Participate. Do more than care. Help. Do more than believe. Practice. Do more than be fair. Be kind. And do more than forgive. Forget. And do more than dream. Work.
Now we know how we too can be great as we serve others. President Speeds, thank you for your superb leadership and service, as well as holding steadfast to our quadrennial theme, a Carolina missionary embracing a new era of innovation for greater service.
That's a beautiful tribute to our president, Sister Adrian Speeds. And now, please enjoy a praise dance by Sister Nia Goodman.
When the leaves turn, I'm reminded of your story. Flourished green gives way to blood red before the fall, choking on harvest apple until daylight savings, the time when the sun shifted in the sky from heaven's throne to flesh and bone to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help me, God, that's gospel. God's only Son provides everlasting life. A world shrouded in darkness being brought back to light. Sight for the blind, might for the weak, restoration and hope for all those who seek shall find. Rewind, restart, hearts rebound when love abounds. The sound of grace is hammer and nail. The never-failing echo of a separation cry that brought everything together. Infinite debtor, paying back penny by penny a debt he'll soon forget. Many have fallen, no, all have fallen short of his glory. But to erase that vast space, that story can be traced back to gospel, a grace offering through sacrificial power and endless love. It's hope and peace, pieced together by brokenness of sun, the light of the world that could not be extinguished like one of those wished upon trick birthday candles. No matter how hard the winds blow, 2 millennia later, we are still singing about the day we were born again. That's gospel, where truth bleeds. Darkness secedes and heaven decrees that the needs of the least of these have been appeased. Hearts seized because God sees instead of turned. Blind eyes are opened, dead hearts are woken, and a new word is spoken when one token brought back an unlimited prize of mercy that surely is gospel. When good overwhelms sin, it pushed evil over its limit because God obliterated separation, pulling everyone into love. So go out, servants, and preach everywhere loudly the gospel that is more than words. Today, right now, in this place, we live it proudly.
Nia, thank you for blessing us through the ministry of dance. It was simply amazing. And now, for the moment we've all been waiting for. As Psalm 149 verses 2-3 states, let Israel rejoice in their maker. It's time for our Lena Jones Rice $100 March by District, presented by Sister Victoria Justice. Sister Victoria, get us moving.
Thank you, Amber. Good evening, Carolina region, family and friends around the globe. Welcome to our annual Missionary March. Let's get this party started. We begin this evening with the courageous Charleston, Columbia District, led by Elder and Mrs. Ronzel Manis, followed by Missionary First Lady of the District, Ms. Sonia King. They come to us across our virtual stage to the tune of You Fight On. Come on, y'all. You fight on. You fight on. Keep your sword in your hand. You fight on. Oh, you fight on. You fight on. Keep your sword in your hand. You fight on. Listen, Jordan River. Chilly and cold. Chilly my body, not my soul. Keep your sword in your hand. You fight on. You fight on. Come on, courageous Charleston Columbia District. Strut your stuff.
You fight on.
will have the mighty Durham District, led by Elder and Mrs. Clifton Harris, followed by Missionary First Lady on the District, Mrs. Eloise White. They will be coming across our virtual stage to the tune of Shabbat. Shabbat, hallelujah. Barak, praise the Lord. Shabbat, hallelujah. Barak, praise the Lord. Come on, mighty Durham District, stretch your stuff to the tune of Shabbat.
Come on, put your hands together then.
Shabbat,
hallelujah,
Barak,
praise the Lord.
You're putting the devil up under your feet. Everybody do like this, hit it.
Our virtual stage will be the soul of 85, Winston-Salem, Greenville District, led by the illustrious Elder Faye Houston, Missionary First Lady on the District, Miss Jacqueline Cox Smith. They will be strutting their stuff across the stage to the tune of War by Charles Jenkins and Fellowship Chicago Choir. Might as well put your hands together. Put them together. Put them together. I got joy in my soul. God is in control. I got Satan on my trail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. I got joy in my soul. Come on, soul of Interstate 85, Winston-Salem, Greenville District, strut your stuff tonight across our virtual stage.
Hands together. train. No matter the attack, I won't turn back.
This means war.
Might as well put your hands together. Put them together, come on.
Region, let me let you in on a little secret. Nobody does it like the superlative seventh. Now that's what I call a missionary march. At this time, please welcome Sister Fanny Lee as she presents our Pauline B. Grant Status of Women nominee, as well as an original piece from exhorter Jesse Crockett from Christ Temple CME Church.
Good evening. I will be reading from a presentation written by Jesse L. Crockett, Exhorter, Christ Temple CME Church. We recognize people with awards, plaques, costly gifts, and they matter. Now we hear much about other things and how they matter. We have a person among us who is a perfect example of two words and how they matter. Adrian Spies is that person, and the words overdue, D-U-E, and overdue, D-O, describes her as she carries on her mission for Christ. Overdue, defined, is something done excessive, unpaid, delayed beyond an appointed time. No amount of money can be paid for the service she gives. She gladly accepts calls and requests for information concerning missionary affairs. She will return calls with the help she is asked to give. Overdue is also defined to do in excess, and she does in excess. So many things she is called to do, such as praying, singing, speaking at special events, witnessing, and never hindered Adrian from performing the duties she is assigned to do. She is a humble, anointed leader. We are blessed to have her, an exceptional leader who shows words and all lives matter. Now, on the behalf of the officers and members of the Women's Missionary Society, it is with joy and great pleasure that we welcome our new president and vice president with a plaque. We pray God's blessings upon their leadership.
Congratulations, and well deserved. And now we will have our financial report and the crowning of our new 2021-2022 district president, presented by Sister Betty Doyle. And now we will have the President's Award and presentation to Bishop and Mrs. Walker, presented by President Speeds. As we come to the close of our program, we have a special treat for our illustrious president, Sister Adrian Speeds.
Hello, Madam President, Mrs. Adrian Conrad Speeds. You are such an efficient president that you have made my job as secretary easy. Thank you. Over the past 8 years, you have been a master builder, laying solid foundations and equipping us with the needed tools to build on those solid foundations. The Carolina Region Missionary Society has always been great, and you have followed in the tradition of past presidents of moving us forward and making us greater. Dr. B.E. Mays has a quote that says, "Whatever you do, do it so well that the living, the dead, and the yet unborn could not have done it better. And you, dear friend, have accomplished that. And I know you would say, to God be the glory. Good job, good job."
Greetings to each of you. It is indeed an honor and a privilege to have this opportunity to say thank you to a deserving, phenomenal woman, Mrs. Adrian Spees. Thank you, Adrian, for being compassionate, committed, and having an energetic spirit as you speed to do God's work. It has been a joy to observe you these past 8 years as the movement of God's ways swept through you. You were like a breath of fresh air. I thank you for your cooperation and your willingness to do in a positive manner. thank you for your hard work and going that extra mile. As you close this chapter in your life and prepare to open a new one, I wish you the best as you dedicate yourself, capture your vision, and speed to your next endeavor. Thank you for all that you have done for the Women's Missionary Council. I will miss you as a region president. God bless you. Much love. Thank you.
Mom, I admire you so much. All that I am or hope to be, I owe it to you. You are a faith warrior, a warrior, someone defined as a person who gets up despite the enemy trying to destroy her, a warrior, a woman who declares victory before seeing it, a woman who believes she receives her miracles because she knows the Lord she serves is alive and powerful. A woman I look up to, a woman I am so, so very proud to call mommy. We love
Mom
you.
Dukes.
And Mom Dukes. We love you. Congratulations on 8 wonderful years of service. Continue to blow us away with yes. your greatness. Mwah.
Hello, Madam President. Thank you for your service to the Carolina region. You did an amazing job maintaining and building the tradition of the Women's Missionary Society. Your leadership and follow-through has been instrumental in the success of the growth of the society in the Carolina region. I appreciate that you are willing to collaborate to make our region great. You are organized, disciplined, determined, and a visionary. You are a friend. Thank you for building a pathway which will lead others to greatness. I see greater things for you at the council level. Congratulations on a phenomenal 8 years. Wishing you all the best in the future.
I haven't known Adrian Spees for any length of time. We first met together at a 7th Episcopal District caucus meeting in 2014 at the General Conference. Our friendly exchange continued each time we met years later, and as a Division I leader on the council and Adrian as a departmental secretary for the Rossity Hollis department, it has made things very easy. So we have a real special relationship. I don't know everything about her, by no means. I don't know her that well. But what I do know is that during the 2020 worldwide pandemic, Adrian Spees focused on reaching out and connecting with people and showing that her love for Christ was so important to spread to so many generations. And you can recall that there were 2 specific presentations, one at Christmas and one at Easter. And these were all for the Rossity Hollis department, and the children participated and their families shared in a very inspiring experience. And this is what Adrian is about. She's about bringing people together with the recognition of how important God is in our life and teaching children that. Now, of course, there are virtual events. That has been real good with real-time experiences. We can't be where the people are, but these virtual events allow us to kind of participate. And I found out that there were a couple of occasions where she did speak for Missionary Day. She was a Missionary Day speaker. And one was in Winston-Salem and at the St. John's Church. And the other was recently, not too long ago in 2021, at the Martin Temple CME Church. Those messages that she gave at that time had very lasting impressions, and it showed how God's goodness was in her life, and it showed also the power of prayer. These are the things that she left with people in her messages, and also helping people. That's why missionary work service is really very, very important, and she's very much a part of that. Now, Adrienne Spies' actions, as I have observed over the years, has been a woman of strength, a woman of purpose, and a woman who is grounded in her faith. Some qualities, I might say, might be similar to the virtuous woman from the book of Proverbs. That same kind of spirit that she has can be associated with Mrs. Rossity Hollis, the woman who is named after the department of which she now directs. Rossity Hollis was a hardworking woman. She made many improvements and accomplishments as well, as she was the second Missionary Council president. So Adrienne Spies, God is directing her path. There's no question about that. Just as he did with Rossity Hollis. Those paths cross now. And all of this is a reflection of God's handiwork. This is from my perspective. I'm pleased to have this opportunity for this very special occasion for Adrienne Spies.
As pastor and servant leader of St. John-CME Church, Winston-Salem, on behalf of the St. John-CME Church family, Mrs. Adrienne Conrad Spies, we say congratulations. There's the four things that I thought about you. First thing I want to talk about is the chronicle. This chronicled in the kingdom. You're getting ready to leave as the president of the Carolina region of the Women's Missionary Society. It's chronicled that you served as the secretary, the young adult advisor, the Lena Jones Rice Missionary Secretary. You've also served with the Rossity Hollis, and you've served as a delegate in the year of 2017, 18, and 19 of this Women's Missionary Quadrennium. But not only is it chronicled, we also look at your commitment. As a church, at our local church, you serve as exhorter, steward board chair, Sunday school teacher. You commit with your time, your talent, your treasure, and your testimony. You serve as an administrator and visionary par excellence, and you have set a role model for those desiring to be a good wife, a wonderful mother, a grandmother, a sister, and a mentor. Thirdly, it goes without saying, Sister Adrienne Conrad Spies is a woman of class. There are some things that money cannot buy, like money, manners, and morals. But you have the intelligence and the class. Your presence speaks and exudes grace, class, and style. And finally, we want to leave you with this final confirmation. You are like an Esther. You have been created and called for such a time as this. You're like Eleanor Roosevelt said, well-behaved women seldom make history. So continue making her story. Oh, we're reminded of Maya. Your mission in life is not merely to survive, but to thrive, and to do so with some passion, some compassion, some humor, and some style. Sister, you have all of this. And finally, as you shared with us in your sermon on last Sunday, as you go forth in your new journey and chapter, remember what you told us from Isaiah 41 and 40. Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Go in the peace and the power and the glory. Continue to shatter glass ceilings as you continue to do what God has called you to do in your next step. Peace be with you. Amen.
Hi, Adrienne. Of course, you see me. This is Chris, and I'm excited to be able to do this video. I first, just on behalf of the St. John CME missionaries, we are excited to have had you as our Carolina region president, as well as a part of our local church. And so we first congratulate you on 8 wonderful years and the many ceilings that you've crushed and gone beyond in our financial reports and our different reports that we've had to present on the council level. And personally, I just want to say thank you for believing in me and appointing me Division of Structure Leader. I didn't know that I could do all of that, but you have pushed and allowed me to use my creative abilities for what they may be and pushed me for leadership roles that I may not have known that I was capable of doing. So I'm going to continue to make you proud and the things that you've shown me, the things that you've tasked me to do. Even as you go higher as Rossi T. Hollis Council Secretary, thank you for believing in me. Thank you for trusting me to take on the different roles that you've assigned to me. Know that this is just a video and I get the pleasure of seeing you in person at church so I could tell you thank you all the times that I want. But for now, know that I love you. Know that I appreciate everything you've tried to do for me on and out of missionary as it relates to missionaries and personally. So go forward in your new journey. Thank you for these 8 years. God bless you and I love you. Mwah.
To a missionary extraordinaire, Adrian Spies. We have been so blessed through your gifted, inspired, and talented leadership in greater service to the Carolina region, our communities, and the CME Church. Someone once said, we can only give our best if we serve as if we're serving God Himself. You have given your best because you did it for the Lord. You did not do it out of a sense of duty, but you did it with a sense of delight. You did not do it out of a sense of obligation, but you did it out of a sense of opportunity, so that in all things, God might be praised. And that is what has made you a joy to know and a joy to work with. The Winston-Salem-Greenville District is just proud to have you as our own, for we know that your service will not cease, your enthusiasm will not die, but you will continue to be a light for the Lord. Congratulations on a job well done from your presiding elder who loves you and is so appreciative of all that you have done.
My name is Peyton Carson. I am the grandson of Mrs. Laura Anderson Holloway. Hello, Mrs. Adrian. Just think you were president not by chance, but by God's choosing. He made you the unique person you are. God allowed you to be there for 8 years. As president, to fulfill special purposes for the Carolina Missionary Society. Thank you for including for me to participate at conference 2 years ago as a Rossi T. Hollis and putting a photo of me in a missionary messenger. I did not have enough money to buy you live flowers, so I took $5 out of my piggy bank and Grandma took me to Dollar Tree to get you these yellow silk roses that will last for a long time. I love you.
Congratulations, Nina.
We're so proud of you.
We love you.
You have done such an amazing job, and now is your time to sit back and relax. Congratulations again from all of us.
Hi, Adrian. It has been a pleasure working with you for the past 8 years. I feel a lot has been accomplished under your administration. I pray that you'll be just as successful working with the Rossi T. Hollis Children of the Council. I wish you the best. And if I can assist you in any way, please let me know. Much love, Carolyn.
Good evening, Madam President Spies. Wow,
It has been 8 years since I walked out of my role as president. It has been my esteemed pleasure to watch you grow and maneuver as the president of the Carolina Region Missionary. What an awesome job you have done, working, praying, teaching, and mentoring all of us to greatness. You have brought us creative programs like the Little Big Shot and the Sing-Off during the March, well-orchestrated trainings through our Missionary Institute, and Sunday afternoon workshops. You have kept our missionary wheel turning through the pandemic by keeping us connected in fellowship through wonderful and spiritually uplifting programs. Your leadership has been exemplary, and for that, we are grateful. Your energy has been contagious and your organizational skills impeccable. Thank you for allowing God to use you and for you using your gifts to his glory. You have left an imprint on each of us that will remind us forever of your legacy of leadership. So I close by saying, good job, good job. G-O-O-D-J-O-B, good job, good job. Thank you, Adrian. You're an awesome woman of God.
President Speeds, as you prepare to pass the baton, I simply want to say, G-O-O-D-J-O-B, good job, good job. Carolina Region, it's been a sheer blessing and honor in being your Lena Jones Rice Missionary March Mistress of Ceremony again this year. My prayer is to fellowship with each of you in the physical next year. Until next time, keep giving, keep loving, keep forgiving, and keep smiling as we continue to build the kingdom of Christ together.